Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Today, let me show you how to create simple animation using Keynote on your Mac. MacMost is supported thanks to viewers like you. Go to MacMost.com/Patreon. There, you could read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content. So you may think of Keynote as a presentation tool, and that's primarily what people use it for. But you can also use it to create simple animations. You can have the animations just on a slide during a presentation, or you can build an animation just for its own sake to use as an animated GIF or to maybe insert in a video you're making. So I'm starting off here with just a single slide in a Keynote presentation, and there are some shapes on it. I've got a blue rectangle here. I've got a narrow gray rectangle here to represent a little road. I've got a brown rectangle that's actually using a gradient fill to go from two shades of brown. And I have a shape here, just a mountain shape. I went to insert a shape here and I just searched for mountain and used that shape there and then changed its color. Now you don't have to use shapes. You can bring in graphics from a graphics app or photos or anything that you want. I'm just using shapes here to keep things simple. I'm going to add another shape, that of a car, and I want to have that car race across the road. So I'm going to take that car, I'm going to put it on the road for now, and I could change its color to whatever I want and shrink it down maybe a little bit. Stick it there on the road. Now I want to have it animate from left to right. To do that I need to create a path for it to animate on. To create a path you want to create a shape and you want to go to basic shapes. You can use either a line or you can click here on the pen to draw a more complex path. I'm just going to use a simple line here. And I'm going to move the right side of the line off of the right side here and the left side off of the left side. Now with the line selected I want to shift click the car so I have both the car and the line selected. I'm then going to go to Format, then Shapes and Lines and Make Motion Path from Shape. It's then going to ask me to click on which shape I want to be the path. So I'll click on the line. You can see it even changes to red as I move my cursor over it. And once I've done that you can see the car now appears on the left side and the right side of the line. Now I'm going to click off here and click the line again. The line remains there as an independent item. I'm going to hit the delete key to delete it. The path is still there with the car. So if I click on the car which is now only in its starting position here on the left you can see I get a little red diamond. I click on the red diamond and it shows me the full path for the car. If I click on animate for the sidebar here and make sure I have action selected. You can see it's set to move. I can hit the preview button and I can preview the car moving across the road. Now I can change some things. I can change the duration so I can maybe make it 3 seconds instead of 1 second. I can also change the acceleration. I want the car to move at a consistent speed so I don't want to do an ease in or ease out or anything. Just none. And I can test again with preview. And now I can see it move. It's not quite on the road anymore as the center of the car is lining up with the center of the line. So I'm going to click off and then click on the car again, this time not showing the path, and I'm going to move it up a little bit. So just use the up arrow. And if I click on the line there, you can see it move the entire line up. I can preview it and I can see it move across on the road just like I want it. So I've animated my first item. Now let's add a second animated element to this scene. So I'm going to go to shape here and I'm going to search for the sun, come up with this graphic here. I'm going to put it in the sky, make it a little bit bigger and also maybe color it appropriately. And the idea is I want to have the sun set. So I want to have it start up here above the image. If you can't see enough you could always zoom out more to see more of the area around it. So I'm going to have it start here. I'm going to add a shape. Do a basic shape, a line, and then take one part of the line and stick it all the way up here and the other part of the line put below. And then I'm going to select both like I did before, do Format, Shapes and Lines, Make Motion Path, click on the shape there. Let me click on the line, get rid of that, click on the sun here and let's animate this. And you can see it's the sun rising. I did that on purpose because I want to show you how to switch this. So I'm going to click on the red line here and all I need to do is just basically drag the points to other ends here. So now it should animate in the right way. And I can preview it now and now you can see the sun set. But I want to have it set behind the mountains and the ground obviously. So what I'm going to do here is click outside to get away from the animation. Click on the sun and I can send it back. So I'm going to do arrange. I'm going to send it back. But I want it to be in front of the background there. So I'm going to move it temporarily. And I'm just going to go to arrange and then bring forward. And you can see it's Option Shift Command F if I need to do it a bunch of times. So that's enough to bring it forward in front of blue here. But you can see it's behind the mountains, behind the ground. So now I can position it where I want again and preview it. And you can see it sets behind the mountains. I also want to set the acceleration to none again and maybe change its duration to something slower, a few seconds there, like that. Now that I have two animations though, I need to control when each one happens relative to the other. So I'm going to go and click on the Build Order button at the bottom of the action sidebar there. And I'll see both of the things I want to animate here. I can click on each one and it selects it. So this makes it a handy way to select those items, especially when they're hard to select because they're behind other things or kind of semi-hidden. So I can see first it's going to do the car and that's going to start on a click. I don't want it to do that. I want it to start immediately right after the transition. Then it's going to do the sun and I want that to actually happen. I could do it with build one so it happens at the same time as the car is moving or after. In this case I want to do it after. So it puts the two of them together but it has a line separating them. So now I can hit the preview button at the bottom of this and I can see both things happen in the proper order. So the car will move across first and then the sun will set. So far we've got two things that move. But animation can be more than just movement. For instance, we can have something fade in or out or change in some other way. I'm going to take this blue sky here and it would be cool if the blue sky faded away as the sun set and revealed what was behind it. What's behind it? Well, I have a black rectangle behind it and a bunch of little white circles to represent stars. So if the blue would fade away, you'd end up with the night sky. That'll be a nice effect to have as the sun sets. I'm going to select Animate for the sidebar and Action and add an effect. And instead of doing a move effect, I'm going to do Opacity here. And you can see it fades out. I'm going to actually have it fade to zero, so disappear completely. And I can do Acceleration. I'll set that to none. Then I'll click on Build Order to bring that up again. So I could see here I've got the car moving, I've got the sun setting, and I've got the rectangle here changing opacity. And that'll happen afterwards, so I want to set it to have happen after build 2. So now let's look at what happens when I preview. You can see the car race by, the sunset, and then the sky fade to black. Now if I wanted the fading to actually start earlier, what I could do is instead of saying after build 2, do it with build 2. Now that'll have the sky turn to black as the sun is setting. That's not exactly what I want. But I could add a delay here. So I know the sun setting takes 3 seconds. That's what I set it to. So I can say let's have a delay of 2 seconds. So the first 2 seconds the sun is setting, the rectangle stays fully opaque. And then in the last second it starts fading out. So now let's preview it. So there's the car and there's the sun and the sky is still blue. And now just at the end there the sky fades and you get the stars. Now I want to show you what happens when you have a more complex path. So let's select the rectangle here. I'm going to hit the delete key to get rid of that. So it's just going to stay a blue sky. I'm going to select the sun here. And what I'm going to do is take this line and use this dot here in the middle. And I can change the path by clicking on it and then dragging it. And I can make a curved path for the sun. So I actually have the start point, the end point, and this curved path here. So let's go and make the start point over here. Make the end point over here and we could change the curve to be here in the middle. So now we could do something like that. We can preview it and see that we get the car and then the sun goes up and over. If we wanted to, we could make the path even more complex. Notice if I move the cursor in between the points, I get more curves. So I can do things like that and that, you know, make it all sorts of crazy kind of curvy things. And now you're really going to get a strange path for the sun. You could also start off with an odd path. So I'm going to go to change here and change none. Remove the actual path for the sun. And you know, here it is. It's now just behind the ground where it started. So I could create a path here by going to Shape, clicking the Pen tool, and then I could draw all sorts of things. So I could have it start here, and you could say I could do straight lines like that, do a crazy path like that, and then I'll just double click here at the end. I'm finished. Select both the sun and the line, then do Format, Shapes and Lines, Make Motion Path, click on that, remove the line. I'll select the sun. I could barely see it there. I could see its path like that and edit it if I want, and I could preview it too. If instead I wanted something to rotate, I could click Add an Effect and say Rotate. I could set whether it's clockwise or counterclockwise how much to rotate, or just set the number of rotations. So I could have it do say 10 rotations. So now when I preview it, see it spins pretty quickly. Let's go and change this to 30 seconds, and you can see now it spins a little slower. Change the ease in and ease out so it's a consistent speed, and you get a little rotation like that. To have the sun rotate while the car is racing by, I'm going to bring in the build order again. I'm going to move the sun up here, and you can see I can move it here with the car, set to start after the transition with no delay. Set the car to start not after build one, but with build one with no delay. When I go to preview, the sun is rotating while the car is racing across. And then of course I can combine movement with this. So I can click on the sun here. I can create a line like I had before. You know, set that up so that the sun moves and sets maybe here at an angle. Set it to make motion path. Delete the line. Let's move this up there a little bit. And you can see here in the build order I have two suns here. It's the sun rotate and sun move. So I can move this up here and have the sun will rotate after the transition. It will start with build one, and the car will start with build one as well. Let's change the move so it does it a little slower, like over 5 seconds. And now when I preview it, you can see the sun will set and rotate at the same time. So in addition to movement, opacity, and rotation, you could also scale objects over time. And by combining all those, there's really a lot you can do to move objects around. What you really can't do is have frame-based animation, a character walk across a screen and you see their legs move. But there's still a lot you can do in Keynote without having to jump to a more professional animation tool. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.